Hello guys, welcome back to Smart Engineering Academy. Myself Amit. In the last two lecture series, I had explained the complete details about CPage analysis. So in this session, let us solve some of the important MCQs. Okay. Let me come into the first question. They have given some statements and they are told which is the right statement and which is the wrong statement. Fine. So consider the following statements. Okay. Periodic line in a earthen dam. First of all, what is periodic line? If I am drawing a dam like this, so flow lines will be like this. And here the drainage is provided. And there will be equipotential line. So the topmost line, the topmost flow line inside the dam structure is called as periodic line. Periodic line. At the point of periodic line, the pressure head will be zero. Upon the periodic line, it is not subjected to any moisture content, because the water and the moisture flow take place only up to the periodic line. The topmost line is called as periodic line, that we had discussed in the previous video. So periodic line of an earthen dam, is it elliptical in shape? I told you the shape of the periodic line is always parabolic. Okay. See, in the yesterday's lecture, I told the MCQ points in that video itself. See, that is what they are coming. Elliptical in shape, it is wrong, because the shape of the periodic line is parabolic. First one, periodic line is a equipotential line. Is it a equipotential line, periodic line? No, it is a flow line. It is not at all equipotential line. So the second statement is wrong. Third one, the topmost flow line with zero water. I told you this is the topmost flow line with zero water. Above that, the pressure at the periodic line will be zero. Above that, there will be, it is not subjected to any pressure of the water. So that point is right. Then coming into the fourth point, pressure approximately a parabola. I mean, the shape of the periodic line is approximately a parabola, right? So 3 and 4 are right options. Fine. So this is how you need to analyze the MCQs. Let me move into the next question. Yes. For a flow net, information can be obtained. So what is, first of all, what is flow net? So we know at the bottom of the dam, if this is flow line, then this is equipotential line. The combination of flow line and equipotential line is called as flow net. The complete thing, this thing is called as, it is combinedly called as flow net. Is it fine? So following information can be obtained. They're asking, by drawing the flow net, what are all the following information that you are going to obtain? So what is the uses of drawing the flow net? First one is to find the quantity of seepage. Fine. Second one, to find the seepage pressure at a point. And third one, to find the uplift pressure. Fourth one, to find the exit gradient. Okay, so the same thing they're asking. First option, to find the rate of flow, that is nothing but a quantity of seepage. This is right. To find the pore water pressure, nothing but seepage pressure. This is right. Then to find the exit gradient, of course it is right. Then what about permeability? We don't have, we are not supposed to check any permeability by drawing the flow net. So option 4 is wrong. If option 4 is wrong, option A is wrong. C is wrong, because 4 is there only one. Option B is the right thing. This is how you need to analyze the question, by building up the concepts of the particular topic. Fine. So let me move on to the next question. which of the following statement regarding the properties of flow net are correct? So this is flow net. Let me read out the things which is correct. No two flow lines start from the same point. You can see here, from this here, no flow line is starting at the same point. There will be 1 point, 2 point, 3 point, I told you. Okay, part traced by individual particle, they are not supposed to start from a single point like this. Okay, so this point is right. No two flow lines cross each other. They are always parallel to each other. They will never ever cross each other. So this is right. Finally, option C is right. One and two, the both things are right. Next question. They have given some numerical. This numerical, yeah. Flow net constructed. Okay, the flow net is constructed to determine the seepage through an earthen dam, which is homogeneous but anisotropic. The soil is anisotropic. I told in the concept lecture series, I told you what is anisotropic conditions of soil, then what is the formula that is to be used when anisotropic condition is there. Okay, so in these types of points has to be highlighted. Next, give 4 flow channels and 16 equipotential drops. So number of flow lines, they have given it as 4. Then ND, number of equipotential drops is 16. The coefficient of permeability in the horizontal and vertical directions is 4 × 10⁻⁷ meter per second and 1 × 10⁻⁷ meter per second. So they have given permeability in the x direction, permeability in the y direction. Permeability in the x direction is 4 × 10⁻⁷ meter per second and ky is 1 × 10⁻⁷ meter per second. By making use of these two things, we can find the value of k, which is equal to root of kx into ky. In case of anisotropic soils, there will be two coefficients of permeability, that is one in x direction and the other one is in y direction. In the x direction they have given. So if you calculate these two values, you are supposed to get the value of k is equal to 2 × 10⁻⁷ meter per second. Is it fine? So respectively. Next, if the storage head is 20 meter, then seepage per unit length of the dam in meter cube per second will be equal to, so storage head, the value of h is given here, the value of h is 20 meters. So they are asking us to find q per unit length. The formula is equal to q is equal to k into h into number of flow lines divided by number of equipotential drop. If you substitute the values, you are supposed to get the answer is equal to q is equal to 10 × 10⁻⁷ meter cube per second per meter. So 10 × 10⁻⁷ is the right answer for this question. Is it fine? Let us move on to the next question. So periodic line in an earthen dam may be. So what is periodic line? Please do comment in the comment section. Periodic line of the earthen dam, it will always be parabolic, which we have discussed many a times. Flow net is used to find. So what is the flow net is used to find? In the previous we have studied permeability of the soil. Is it used to find the permeability of soil? No, we are not finding permeability. Strength of the soil? Not at all. Quantity of the seepage? Of course, we are supposed to find quantity of the seepage. Bearing capacity of the soil? No. So the option C is right. Please do comment in the comment section. What are all the uses? There are like 4 uses of the flow net. What are all those 4 uses? So it will be a revision for you, even though I told you previous, not an issue. Please do comment in the comment section. So without wasting any time, let me move on to the next question. So they have given some numerical. A soil has a discharge velocity. They have given discharge velocity. Okay, discharge velocity is equal to 6 × 10⁻⁷ meter per second. and the void ratio, void ratio is equal to 0.5. its seepage velocity vs seepage velocity is represented in terms of vs. They're asking us to find what is the seepage velocity. So formula for seepage velocity is equal to vs is equal to discharge velocity divided by n. N is nothing but nu. You can take it as nu, which is equal to porosity. Nu is equal to E divided by 1 plus E. The value of E is 0.5. If you substitute this value here, you're supposed to get the value of nu is equal to 0.333. Then Vs is equal to, what is the value of V? 6 into 10 power minus 7, and nu is 0.333. And you are going to get the value is equal to 18 into 10 power minus 7 meter per second. So option B is the right answer. Then again, the same question is repeating. The shape of the periodic line is, of course, parabola. Seepage through the earthen dam can be computed by the following equation with usual notation. Seepage is equal to Q is equal to K into H into number of flow lines divided by number of equipotential drops. Q is equal to KH into NF by ND. Direct question. Just a minute. Yes. Next, they have given some numerical. Coefficient of permeability of the soil having a void ratio. The value of the void ratio they have given is 0.50. And coefficient of percolation. Coefficient of percolation is represented in terms of Kp, which is equal to 3 into 10 power minus 4 centimeter per second. Okay. Then the value of they are asking us to find the value of permeability. So Kp is equal to K by nu. So K is equal to Kp into nu, where the value of Kp is equal to 3 into 10 power minus 4 and nu. Nu is equal to E by 1 plus E, 0.50 divided by 1 plus 0.50. If you substitute this value, you are supposed to get the value as one into 10 power minus 4 centimeter per second will be the right answer. So find solve some more MCQs. If any kinds of doubts, please do comment in the comment section. Thank you guys. So I'll come up with some more units, that is seepage pressure and hydraulic gradient. Effective stresses I already completed, and bearing stress distribution, bearing capacity of the soil. I'll come up with the remaining units. In the parallelly, I am running structural analysis topic also. In the structural analysis topic, I had already completed static indeterminacy with a detailed analysis with concepts as well as MCQ. And next, I'm uploading the videos of kinematic indeterminacy. Later on, I will follow with arches, 3-inch arches, 2-inch arches, influence line diagram, moment distribution method, and everything. So thank you guys. Thank you. Bye-bye.